everyone and welcome. This is Melissa Armo and I own the stock Swoosh. And today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about money management. When you're taking a trade, whether you're doing options, whether you're doing day trades, whether you're doing swing trading, whatever the type of trading that you're doing is, you should be consistent with your money management. Now, what do I mean? I mean how much money you're risking per trade. So say, for example, you take five options trades, okay? If one of them you risk $500, one of them you risk $1,000, one of them you risk $2,000, and so on and so forth, then you're not going to have consistent results. You have to try to keep your risk aligned, even Steven. And again, this isn't an exact science. So you want to try to keep it as close as you can. So for example, say you decide you want your risk to be $1,000 per trade in each options trade. It's okay if you risk $1,100. Or if you risk 900, but it wouldn't be okay if you risk 2000, because then you would be taking double the risk in that one specific trade. So then if that trade would lose, then you'd have to take up two trades that would be good winning trades just to make up the difference to cover the loss. And they would have to be 100% in gains. Do you follow me? So it's always good to keep your risk consistent. So that's a very important lesson. I just want to remind everyone out there, and I think people don't realize that. I think sometimes people just take trades and they, you know, and if they don't go right away, maybe they kill them. But the fact is, the idea of taking a trade, if it's a good trade, which every single trade that you should take should be a good trade, it's the idea of giving the trade a chance to work. And if your risk is too high and the trade is down a little bit, you'll get scared out of it and want to kill it and won't give it the ample time to move and work, particularly options. If you have too big of a risk on, or you've oversized yourself based on your normal sizing. So right now, think about that. Think about your risk. Think about whether or not it's consistent. And more importantly, decide what you want your risk to be. So your total risk per trade really also should be determined by the size of your cash in your account. And again, that's up to you. But I really think it's important if you are new, if you're a beginner, or if you have a small account, that your risk should be small. If you've been trading for a while or you have a larger account, then you can take more risk, obviously. But green is green, whether it's $100 or $1,000. So the important thing is to make money. How do I do that? Well, I use my Golden Gap rating system. That's how I make the picks for the options trades and the day trades. If you'd like more information, you can email me at Melissa@thestockswoosh.com. Thanks, everybody, and have a great day.